Hi everybody, today is February 8th, 2013. Here's some information about that asteroid that's supposed to pass by Earth on the 15th. On February 15th, 2013, an asteroid about the size of a football field will fly by Earth only 7,200 miles above the planet's surface. To give you an idea how close that is, that's like driving from California to New York about 5 times, or maybe 5.5 times. That's how close it is. And there's no danger of a collision, they say. But the space rock, and it is a rock, it's not a snowball, it's a solid rock, designated 2012 DA14. And it's interesting, it's going to go by on the 15th, and DA, like day 14, we'll just have to see. It has NASA's attention. This is a record-setting close approach, says Don Yeomans of NASA Near Earth Object Program at JPL. Since regular sky surveys began in the 1990s, we've never seen an object this big get so close to Earth. The Earth's neighborhood is littered with asteroids of all shapes and sizes, ranging from fragments smaller than a beach ball to mountainous rocks many kilometers wide. Many of these objects hail from the asteroid belt, while others may be corpses of long-dead burnt-out comets. A burned-out comet? NASA's Near Earth Object Program helps find and keep track of them, especially the ones that come close to our planet. 2012 DA14 is a fairly typical near-Earth asteroid. I like how they call it typical. Does this happen all the time? This is a typical close approach? No, it's not. It measures some 15 meters wide, neither very large nor very small, and is probably made of stone as opposed to metal or ice. Yeomans estimates that the asteroid, like 2012 DA14, flies past Earth on the average every 40 years. It actually strikes our planet only every 1,200 years or so. But yet it's a typical near-Earth asteroid. Sounds like a lot of double talk there. The impact of a 50-meter asteroid is not cataclysmic, unless you happen to be underneath it. Yeoman points out that a similar object formed a mile-wide meteor crater in Arizona when it struck about 50,000 years ago. That asteroid was made of iron, he said, which made it especially potent impact. Also, in 1908, something about the size of 2012 DA14 exploded in the atmosphere above Siberia, leveling hundreds of square miles of forest. Researchers are still studying the Tunguska event for clues of the impacting object. 2012 DA14 will definitely not hit Earth, emphasizes Yeoman. The object of the asteroid is known well enough to rule out an impact. They leave out the fact that if it does bump into something, it could change its course. And then you have the gravitational effect of the moon and other planets. Even so, I like that, how they add the even so. It will come interestingly close. NASA radars will be monitoring the space rock as it approaches Earth closer than many man-made satellites. Now remember, to give you an idea how close it's going to come, all you need to do is visualize driving from California to New York 5.5 times. Or another example, driving from California to New York and back 2.5 times. Yeoman says the asteroid will thread the gap between low Earth orbit, where the ISS and many Earth observation satellites are located, and the highest belt of geosynchronous satellites, which provide weather data and telecommunications. The odds of an impact with a satellite are extremely remote, he says. Almost nothing orbits where DA14 will pass the Earth. NASA's Goldstone radar in the Mojave Desert is scheduled to ping 2012 DA14 almost every day from February 16th through the 20th. The echoes will not only pinpoint the orbit of the asteroid, allowing researchers to better predict future encounters, but also reveal physical characteristics such as size, spin, and reflectivity. A key outcome of the observing campaign will be a 3D radar map showing the space rock from all sides. During the hours around close approach, the asteroid will brighten until it resembles a star of 8 magnitude. Theoretically, that's an easy target for backyard telescopes. The problem, points out Yeoman, is speed. The asteroid will be racing across the sky, moving almost a full degree or twice the width of a full moon every minute. It's going to be hard to track. Only the most experienced amateur astronomers are likely to succeed. Those who do might experience a tiny chill when they look at their images. That really was a close shave. Now, according to Earth Changes Media, NASA is trying to calm fears of this near-miss asteroid. Mitch Bartros, Earth Changes Media. NASA held a media teleconference yesterday, Thursday, on the 7th, to discuss asteroid 2012 DA14. Now, he says that he would suggest that NASA is a bit more nervous than they project. He says that he counted between 11 and 15 disclaimers during their conference. They also produced 3 videos, also with punctuated disclaimers. He says, I'm not saying that they're hiding information, I'm just saying they're probably a few beads of sweat on those monitoring. And then he lists some different questions and answers, like, what is asteroid DA14? It's approximately 150 feet, 45 meters in diameter. Close approach will be on the 15th at 2:24 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Says this time may change by a minute or two as the asteroid is tracked on its approach and predictions are refined. Like I was saying, there's a lot of different things that could affect its trajectory and time, of course. But as it stands right now, they think it's going to be over the Indian Ocean off Sumatra, and it gives the latitude of 6 degrees, longitude 97.5 degrees east. Close approach will be about 17,200 miles above the Earth's surface at the time of closest approach. And it says distance will be well outside Earth's atmosphere, but it's still inside the belt of satellites. And satellites fly at 22,200 miles above the Earth's surface. Another way to express the distance between asteroid and Earth at the time of the closest approach is 4.4 Earth radius from the Earth's surface, or about twice the diameter of the Earth. All right, so I'll give you a link to both these articles. Bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.